Hello, friends and strangers. I am Hayley, and in this video, I am taking you with me into epic battle fantasy 5. Looks like holy damage will work fine here. No legs can do his usual thing. And ice damage from Natalie. There we go. Right. No secrets. Let's continue on our way. Bots and fallen. Lightning damage will work, at least against the bots. Natalie, you can try bombs. That was the Well, actually, it did work on the bots, never mind. Wasn't the wrong thing at all. And just a drowned fallen left. Oh. No legs? Yeah. And now we can see about this. A wooden key and an opal. Right, let's head back. Now. Pizza and chicken leg. What we need to do is find our way back to the lava lake and get that final lava sample. Then we can complete that quest. And hopefully get some kind of an awesome reward. Hey, what you guys did for me really saved my life. We all gotta do what we can for this little simulated world of ours. None of us have to suffer alone. I'll be rooting for ya. Glad you're doing better. We'll make this a world worth living in again, I promise. I hope we can keep that promise. I think it was this way. Yeah, right over here. Okay, that's all we came here for.
Hello.
Perfect. I'll package these up and here we go. Please deliver this back to the lab in the Iron Fortress. They have the equipment required to analyze these samples. And we got some empty bottles, snail mail, and a star ball. To the Iron Fortress, huh? It's been a while. You can do it. I saw you fight. No one else matches you in power and technique. If you fail, our world is doomed. Thanks for putting so much pressure on us. Aww. To the Iron Fortress. Let's tie up all the loose ends we can before we put those orb thingies in their places and start the final encounter. What? You got news from the crater? Yeah, that confirms it. These invaders are from another world. Well, we've studied their energy source and invented this new magic skill. Black Hole, Limit Break, deals massive magical dark damage to all foes and makes them heavy. Also, kills the user. Rubber Boots, allows the party to walk on acidic tiles, but there aren't any of those in the game at the moment. Huh. Right. This way. Yeah, that's quite a limit break skill we just got. Also kills the user. Added as an afterthought. Let's go and see about this Illuminati symbol thingy. Oh, there's no way we can get on the water from here. Let's try this way. Nope. I guess we could just walk over to Red Pine Town and get on the water from there. Or is there a way from over here? Yeah, looks like we can just walk. So the symbol of the Illuminati, I think it was a triangle that points up. Yes. Geodes and Thor's hammer boosts the damage of thunder skills. Alright. I don't think we need these skulls for anything anymore. Might as well leave them here. And I think we've done all we can here. So the next thing we do will be to put the orbs in their places and see what happens then. And kind of in preparation for that, I'm upgrading all of the equipment I can so that we'll be as prepared as possible for anything. never hurts to be well prepared. I guess we could upgrade this one as well. Oh. Let's find the Red Pine Town item shop and use our money to buy the stuff we need to upgrade our equipment. Oh, there's a completed quest. Cheers, matey. With these bottles, I can sail off out of here. I don't want to die on this godcat-forsaken continent. I'll teach you one final skill before I go. Hidden power. Limit break. Deals massive physical or magical damage to all foes. Damage type is based on highest stat. Element and effects depend on current weapon. Okay. Let's see. I think we want to give this to No Legs. Oops, didn't mean to do that. Who do I want to give the self-destruct black hole to? It kind of seems like a lance kind of skill. Yeah, let's give it to Lance. Dark and dangerous. Although, No Legs does have those auto-revive skills, or at least one skill that gives everybody auto-revive. So I guess the black hole isn't all that permanently deadly. Let's go and find that item shop. Oh, what did we need to buy? Big lava slime. Can't buy that. And also, I don't think we want to upgrade that because we have a better wind sword. P2 processors. Emeralds, tape, and nanofiber. Alright. Emeralds. Nanofiber. And finally, tape. Now we should be able to upgrade those staves. And this one requires sapphires. Expensive. Well, not as expensive as the nanofiber. But I don't think we'll need money a whole lot. Where we are going, we'll just need better stuff. So spending our money on on upgrading is the smart thing to do, I think. I think the game hinted at it pretty heavily at one point. Told us to basically use all our money and resources while we still can. Upgrade stuff and basically make us as powerful as we can. We do still have a couple of unfinished quests left. But thing is, I don't know where to get those last three golden tickets. Or that one final orb thingy. So we might as well go and see if we can finish the game without completing those quests. Oh, that's expensive. Let's see, what else do we want to upgrade? Let's buy some emeralds. Just in case we need specific elements and resistances and things. I think it's good to be prepared. Okay, do we want to upgrade our armor? Everything is already pretty high level. And I guess if we lose, we can just come back and upgrade these things then. Yeah, let's go and see what happens when we put the orb thingies in place. Yeah, one of those and three of those. I don't know where to find them. This way, I think. And here we are. Let's put them in place. And we get a teleport. Ah, my stuff! Whoa, what's happening? Looks like we're blasting off again. Woohoo, this is fun! There's no gravity here. We're being sucked through an interdimensional wormhole. There's no telling where we will end up. It could even be on the other side of the galaxy. It's okay. I blindly trust this strange alien portal. There's a light up ahead. I think we're almost there. We're in space? Are we going to suffocate? Whoa, we're really high up. Is that what the Earth looks like from so far away? I can breathe just fine though. Why would we suffocate? This is not normal. Is this real life or just fantasy? The laws of the universe shouldn't allow such a place to exist. Is this a pocket universe? An area of space-time separated from our world by dimensional barriers? Did the monoliths create this? Their controller must be here. Whatever's been commanding the monoliths, this would be the best place for it to hide itself. I didn't understand much of that. But whatever has that sort of power is not going to let us kill it easily. Meow, meow. Agreed. We should stay confident and get ready for whatever challenges await us here. Looks like earth and holy damage. Nolex can just do his thing. Oh, and yeah, fire damage will work too. Ouch. Oh yeah, falling stars. That's a weird type of weather to have. Alright, only two left. That's that. Gunpowder and titanium. Oh yeah, there's something in these pillars. Well, let's do this fight first. Cosmic monoliths, lightning and water. Let's just make sure that Anna doesn't give them their health back when counterattacking. And the same goes for Natalie. This has very bad stats though. I think we still want to give her this. This feels like a good time to start defending ourselves. I'm sure it would be. Let's see. I guess we're going with Annihilate. Oh. Water damage. Lightning. Watch out. Whoa. Yeah, it was a good thing I changed her bow. That spell may look simple, but the special effect depends on my staff, so it can potentially inflict some rare effects. Yeah, it was a good thing that we changed her bow. Brace for a total party kill. It wasn't quite a total party kill, though. Let's bring in Matt. Put Natalie into reserve. Or backup, I guess. See, I think this sword is the lightning, yes. All right. Okay, almost done. And that did it. Finally. For stone blocks, they have very high evade. Let's get these dark runes. Anything else? I guess not. Okay, let's start jumping around. Gunpowder. And what was that? Ooh, mithril shards. Whoa, that chibi knight thing is back, and she's all decked out in some epic armor. It wouldn't fit me anyway, but maybe no legs? Earth and bio. I guess we could change his sword. Yeah, let's do it. It'll be worth it. Natalie. Oh yeah, you do have this earth skill that hits all enemies. She's an energetic little one. I'll give her that. I guess we should scan her. Ultra Chibi Knight. Weak to darkness and bio. Let's heal everybody. Natalie can just keep doing this. Knock it off, you Meta Knight wannabe. Vines work pretty well against her as well. Ouch, no legs. In a few days, she's went from being a scrub to an actual boss. Maybe soon she'll be an actual player character. Let's do some holy damage. And also give No Legs auto revive, just in case. I guess we could also use Matt's limit break. That was the worst thing I've ever eaten, and I have no standards. Was that even food? I wonder what he ate. Oh well. We have done most quests and upgraded most things. I don't think we desperately need any of the food items we have in storage. So the hunger effect isn't quite as bad as it used to be. It looks like she wants to be a hero too. I bet she's just annoyed that we're the main characters. Maybe. We haven't really heaped very many negative status effects on her. Yeah. Oh well. She can command mammoths so easily. I think we've really underestimated her. Oh, I guess she wasn't a player character after all. I don't think we'll ever see her again now. We probably didn't have to kill her. Well, I did try to capture her, but she wouldn't have any of it. So... sorry, not sorry. Beyond. Well, let's save here for now and continue exploring this place next time. If you like this video, please leave it a like. And if you'd like to support my efforts here on YouTube, please subscribe to my channel. It is quick and easy and doesn't cost you a thing. But it does help me a lot. Thanks so much for watching. I wish you a lovely rest of your day, and I hope to see you in the comments below.